Hey guys, I just wanted you to see something peculiar. What would you call that? I know a lot of people in the past have called it, someone took my pineapple top. Honestly, like someone stole my pineapple top. I don't know where it went. It's not on the cards anywhere, but this is a little bit more important to take a look at these digital clouds right here. Absolutely not natural. That kind of patterning is formed by the haarp waves interfering with the particulate in the atmosphere up there. Besides haarp waves, there's all kinds of radio frequencies that can be emitted to make that happen. And that's what that is. So none of your when you have a blue sky like that, they need to eliminate that as quickly as possible because they want to block our beautiful sun. Sorry, camera shut off there, but I wanted to show you how they form out of nowhere, just like that. And you're going to see their wave patterns. And what it is that wave pattern, not natural to nature, because you know in nature that nothing, is perfect. You know, everything, well, it's perfect in its imperfection. You know what I mean? There's no, like, exact lines. But see how it's perfectly spaced between them? Like that. That's the abnormal part of this. It's like straight lines in nature. Now, if you look at the edge, I don't know what I'm seeing here. Hold on. Let me back it out a little bit. If you look at the edge of that right there, you'll see them form out of nowhere. Watch. I'll leave it on for half a second. I don't have much time on this film. But, you can see them form across the whole sky. Now, there's no moisture. So they're utilizing whatever moisture is up there right now, or they're from all the spray from aluminum or whatever to create any kind of condensate particle to allow that to happen. Look how much that grew. Look at that. You know what it looks like if you look at cymatics? Cymatics, I think it's called cymatics or whatever, cymatics. You'll see how that vibration creates that. It's like vibrating a wok lid. Put some water in a wok lid and vibrate it. Like you hit it with like a mallet or something or a drumstick, and you'll see the water do that pattern. It's vibration, and that's what waves and that's what these frequencies are doing. Is they're vibrating the particles up there to create that kind of a thing. It's like a speaker next to styrofoam or water. It'll create a pattern in the water. But you can see it for yourself. It's nothing out of the blue, literally. I mean, I've been talking about this for a long time. See, right there forming? I've shown lots of videos on this happening. This is a phenomenon they're going to name on the news, mackerel clouds or some crap. But you see it forming right there on the left? See those lines just growing and growing and growing? Watch. You'll see that grow. There's two there. There's three. They're starting to come. You see it? I'm running out of film, so I'm going to keep that on there as long as possible, and you watch that form. See, look at it from the whole thing is there. Look at that thing grew like a monster. And looks like somebody vibrating a wok lid of water, and then they're here. Vibration is just creating the atmosphere right there. And all that vibration is affecting your cells, affecting your... What the hell was that? Affecting your butt, body, and stuff. You'll hear it on the film. I don't know what that was, some kind of reaction to the weather. I always talk about those little cold pockets, and they stop the storms from rising right there. See that dark spot, that dark layer? That's a lot of cold, moist air right there, like frozen air, basically, and that keeps any kind of storm activity from advancing higher. It doesn't allow that hot air to punch up and through, so that they can utilize whatever moisture is up there to create these things. Look, it grew. Where is it? Hold on. Back it up. Right there. And actually, I'm seeing something happening up inside of it. Like a little dot just went off. Like it looked like a little burst. Could be pyrotechnics or something. I'm not sure. They have so many different sciences. Look up cloud seeding pyrotechnics. Look up solar radiation management. I'll put a link down in the description. There's your beautiful sun. No worries that my camera lens will get damaged with all that crap in here. And there you go. There's some trails right out there in the distance. Laying down the sky. See? So they go to the edge of the low pressure, and then they let it just expand. And they're either manipulating this to capture it to make a cloud out of it, or to move it somewhere. And you see all that nasty crap out there. So any kind of blue you had is going to go away from the shield, I call it. It's like this giant shield of ugly chemical crap. Oh, the thing about calling it chemtrails as opposed to calling it geoengineering stuff, like all the different terms, call it solar radiation management. And the government can't deny it, because that's one thing that science is doing at Harvard. It's legally doing it. And chemtrails is a good word for this, because it's all chemical trails. But the point is, the actual trail itself, the chemtrail itself, the term, is what they use for military weaponization. So they can categorically deny that term anytime you say it. I get it. I mean, I know what they are. They are chemtrails. They're full of chemicals, biologicals, metals, all kinds of crap. But the whole point is, yeah, so the terminology they try to convince us to use or not use, it's hard to figure out what you want to use, but they can't deny solar radiation management, because that's a Harvard game. It's not like a military game. Military, they could deny, because for national security. The other shit, they can't. I'm not saying don't say the word chemtrail. I say just shout it as loud as you want. Make people know what the hell this is. Poison trail. I like it, the death dump terms for me is Ted Gunderson's. I love it. Death dump. That's what that is. Death dump. Because people are affected by it every single minute of every day. There's no escaping that. You got to be out of your mind to think that you can run away from that. Not that you're out of your mind. I know that you're not, because you're watching this. Have a good day, guys. Love you and be well. Peace. Please subscribe. I can use all